Good morning, children. Today we are going to start general properties of transitional elements. First of all, we see the metallic character exhibiting what? Metallic character means losing tendency of electrons. See, when you lose electron, whenever you have unpaired electrons, when you have completely filled electrons, it is difficult to remove electron. When you have completely like D10, when you have D10 means what happened? Completely filled electron. Completely filled electrons. They are difficult to remove. So, in the last class I told you, zinc, cadmium, mercury, these three belongs to second B group element. Their configuration is NS2N-1 D10. Do you find any unpaired electron in this? No, there is no unpaired electron. So how it exhibit metallic properties? So their metallic properties are completely different. They are not called transitional elements. I told in the last class, second B group elements, zinc, cadmium, mercury, they do not called as transitional elements because they are having completely filled configuration. Now, coming to the metallic character, malleability, ductility, tensile strength, hard nature, these cannot exhibited by these elements, right? What is malleability, isn't it? You are beating a metal sheet into thin. By you meet just beat a aluminum sheet, iron sheet with a hammer, it will convert into thin sheet actually. That is called malleability. Ductility means deriving wires from that one, deriving gold, copper, isn't it, into wires. Tensile strength means load bearing capacity. Hard nature, all these properties generally exhibited by these transitional element, except what? Zinc, cadmium, mercury, they do not possess because they are having completely filled configuration. Next, what about manganese? Manganese is having D5 configuration even though it is not exhibiting, isn't it, this type of property. There are some of the properties if you observe it, these are not exhibiting here. I will explain that one in the later because of something what? Crystal, typical crystal structure, it is not exhibiting here. Now, all these are having what? They are having typical metallic structures. The properties are what? Completely what happened? Different. You see, observe here, HCP, hexagonal closed packing, close cubic closed packing, body centered closed packing. This type of typical structures are there for this one, but it is not having a typical structure like this. So that we'll discuss in the later. So what I mean to say is that these elements do not exhibit metallic character like transitional elements here. Next, you will see the melting and boiling points actually. Now, being as a metals hard in nature, they're having high melting points. Now, melting points depends upon what character? Generally unpaired electrons. When you have more number of unpaired electrons, definitely you will have more melting point. And when you have more number of unpaired electrons, you should have more number of metallic bondings. More unpaired electrons generally forms metallic bond. For example, I have taken something, scandium is there, it has one unpaired electron. Now it will form one bond with another scandium here. This is called actually what? A metallic bond. Metallic bond, isn't it? For example, titanium. Titanium is having, this is having D1 configuration, right? Titanium, if I take, titanium is having how many? D2. Means how many unpaired electrons you are having? 2. It has 2 unpaired electrons here. Now, it can form how many bondings now? Here 1 and here also 1. Now, this titanium being as D2, 2 unpaired electrons, it can form 2 metallic bondings. When you take what happened? Vanadium. Vanadium D3. 1, 2, 3. Now it will form how many metallic bondings here? 1, 2, 3 metallic bondings. As number of unpaired electrons 1, here 2, here 3. Number of unpaired electrons are increasing, metallic bondings also increases. When metallic bondings are increasing, melting points also increase. Very simple point. As number of unpaired electrons, D1, see, I am explaining it, D1, one unpaired electron. Melting point is 1539 Kelvin temperature. All temperatures are Kelvin temperature. Now, titanium, D2, number of unpaired electrons are 2 here. Metallic bonding is 1668 Kelvin temperature. Yes. Now, vanadium, D3, 3 unpaired electrons. Now, melting point is increased to what? 1900. Now, from chromium, for observe for chromium, number of unpaired electrons in d orbital are how many? 5. Even s also having what? 1 unpaired electron, s1d5, isn't it? So number of electrons are increased now here. So what is the melting point? 1875. So here, from scandium to chromium, number of unpaired electrons from 1, 2, 3, 5, they are increasing. When number of unpaired electrons are increasing, melting point is 1539 to 1875 Kelvin temperature increased here. So surely number of unpaired electrons increasing, number of metallic bondings are also increasing, melting point is increasing. Now coming to this manganese here. Now when you observe, manganese is having also D5 configuration. It is having what? 3D5 4s2 configuration. Now here also you have 5 unpaired electrons, 3d5, 5 unpaired electrons you are having, but melting point is least here, you see, 1539, 1245, not least in this series, but compared to these which I explained from scandium to chromium, very less melting point, 1245 Kelvin temperature, less melting point, even though having half fill configuration. This can be explained by, see, half fill configurations are generally what? Stable. Similarly, just like a completely filled configuration, half filled configuration is also what? Stable. So because of stable electronic configuration, unable to participate in the metallic bondings. See, very simple here, 3d5 is what? Stable half fill configuration, stable half fill electronic configuration. Because of stable half fill configuration, unable to participate in metallic bond. Now here metallic bondings are very weak now here. Because of our stable, no, stable never participate in the bondings here. So weak metallic bondings, therefore weak melting points here. Now after this, what happened? What about iron? Iron is having D6. Configuration is D6. Don't say it is what having what? 6 unpaired electrons. After the manganese, number of unpaired electrons, how do we calculate? 10 minus 6. 10 minus 6. How many you are having? 4 unpaired electrons. Now here it is 1536. Next, cobalt, D7 configuration. Cobalt is having what? D7 configuration. Now 10 minus 7. Number of unpaired electrons, how many? 3 only. In this way we are correct. From here D1, D2, D3, D5, configuration is nothing but number of unpaired electrons. From iron, 10 minus configuration, 10 minus 6, 4 unpaired electrons. Configuration is what? D7. 10 minus 7, 3 unpaired electrons. Configuration in this case, D8. Now 10 minus 8 is equal to 2 unpaired electrons. Now unpaired electrons are decreasing here. So what happened here? Melting point is also decreasing. Now copper, D9, you take as D9 only, but because copper plus 2 is a typical element here. Now what happened? 10 minus 9 is equal to 1 unpaired electron. Now in this I am not writing zinc, cadmium and mercury. Why? Because they are not transitional elements, because they are having completely filled configuration. So what I mean to say is that in any series if you observe, in any series if you observe of the transitional elements, first it will increases, left to right first increases, reaches maximum, then decreases, then after that again increases, then decreases. This way it will exhibit. Now observe what 3D series, scandium to chromium increasing, chromium to manganese decreasing, manganese to iron increasing, then off suddenly what happened? Decreasing. You see again, unpaired electrons are increased here because of what? complete what we call incompletely filled, that is half fill configuration. Because of half fill configuration, stable weak metallic bonding again what happened, increases because of what, the four unpaired electrons, because of four unpaired electrons. After that what happened, number of unpaired electrons decreasing, melting point also decreases. Same thing you can follow in 4D series, even in 5D series here. See here, zirconium to niobium increasing, molybdenum increasing. Why suddenly decreasing? Because of technetium is having what type of configuration? Half fill configuration, it will be stable configuration, decreased. Again increasing, then decreasing. Same pattern we are going to observe here. Here also what happened? Hafnium to tungsten increasing because of ampere tons are increasing. And after this what, rhenium is having again half fill configuration, metallic bondings are decreasing. But here we don't sudden increase. Why? Because in rhenium what happened, because of large size what happened, the metallic bondings, even the half configuration when you compare to this one, does not increase here. This is what, something exception case actually. So what I mean to say is that number of unpaired electrons are increasing, metallic bondings increases, melting points increases. Unpaired electrons are increased, melting points are increased. Then suddenly what happened? Half fill configuration, stable, weak metallic bondings, melting point decreased. Then after that, again unpaired electrons are increased, melting point increased. Again unpaired electrons are decreased. From what happened? From 4 to what happened? 1. In this way, we can explain the melting point here.